Hey, this is Airzone here. I've made a couple of changes to the way that the firmware in the dual stage FDL3 works with the closed loop controllers. And now instead of selecting what RPM you want, you select what FPS you want, and the blaster will do all the necessary calculations to work out what it needs to do to produce that result. So anyway, the best way of sort of covering this is to actually show it. So I have it here. And then what we're going to do is increase this to around about 50 FPS. So when I fire a dart, so it's currently says 50 FPS down the bottom, fire a dart through the cranny, I expect about 50. 44, yeah, give and take plus 10, right? So that's close enough. Now, if I was to change this to just say 80, let's see what happens next. Once again, we should see something around about 80. 74, yeah, I'm okay with that. Now let's do 120. Now, will I get 120 thereabouts? 119. Not bad. Let's go to 150. A little bit hot. Let's go to 180. So, you know, once again, give or take plus minus 10. Let's go to 230. Now I've got 3 left, I think. Yeah, 3 darts left. So 236, that's good enough. Let's go to 260. I think we're starting to reach the ends of where they're efficient. But just to see, let's try 300. I don't expect us to get anywhere close to this. I don't think we're able to reach 300. We'll go to 290. All right, we'll try that. 290. No, the motors are not fast enough for this battery voltage for 290. Let's go down to 280. I think we've reached the maximum limit of what the motors are. Let's go down to 270. We'll try. 270. Nope. Anyway, for the last shot, the maximum that these motors can really do are about 260. I would need a higher KV motor to get any more. But for the next shot, what we'll do is do an even 200. All empty. So as you can see, that's not 100% exact because, I mean, you know, there's differences in each dart and all that sort of stuff, but it gets you pretty close to where you want to be. Anyway, this is AirZone, and closed loop brushless is pretty cool.